Well, 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 here we are. It's Saturday morning. It's Saturday night. And looks like we got the regulars in the chat. Para's here. And of course, the man of the hour is here, who I'm sure is probably sleepy as fuck because he's got twins. Hopefully you guys saw the thumbnail. Looks like you guys did. And oh, we got Sasha. I think Colin's going to be happy about that, Sasha, that you're in. I read his little blurb right now, and, well, let's just say there's an ode to Asha. Asha, Sasha. yeah, I bet you are exhausted, Colin. Scott's here, Manuel, Romelo, and Ryan just showed up. What's up? We got all the people here. Is Ashley going to show up? Got Paravarium here. Para, do you have to go to work, man? We'll try to get through this. I will say this. Today we only have four songs on the list. However, two of them I think are like 10, 12 minute songs. So I think it'll make up for the, that makes up for two songs anyway. So tomorrow, if you guys looked on the little thumbnails, tomorrow we have someone who just randomly wrote me. I got an email from Wick. Is that his name? I think it's Wick. That said, hey, I just wrote a song. I just did the video for it or something like that. Would you please put this on your channel for exposure? And I, you know, I'm all about trying to expose, you know, new music and stuff like that. So if someone asks me to do that and they've put the time and the work into actually creating a new song, I said yes. So tomorrow will be his new song. I think it said when I clicked on it that it had like, I don't know, a couple thousand views or something like that. So sounds like people have been watching it, or some people have been way more than people who watch my channel. Because we only get like 200-300 views to each video that we do. And he's got, you know, 2,000, 3,000 or something like that, I think. But we will add a few more when we do it tomorrow. And then, of course, Scott rounds it off on Monday. And then we are free for the next weekend after that. So I'm excited to get into Colin's set. Colin, thank you and your busyness with the kids to join us live. And hopefully... we like some of the music that you picked for us today. I'm sure the fact that you said that you wanted Sasha in the chat says that he's going to at least like one of them. And I'm sure he'll like more of them because you guys are like two peas in a pod. Maybe you guys are twins of like completely different ages. All right, so let's get into this. Thank you guys for joining. I'm glad it's a Saturday. It's fucking hot as shit. It's 91 degrees here. I'm sure Pyramid will show up and tell you that's the same. And there's like major thunderstorms on the way. So I'm guessing by like 3 or 4 o'clock, it's going to be like raining all day long again. So essentially what we have here in Ohio is it rains almost every day. It's at least every other day at worst. And at best, I guess it should be the opposite of that in describing it because it's the worst. But at best, it rains pretty much every day. So it rained yesterday morning all through the fucking morning for like 5 or 6 hours. And then it got beautiful and kind of too hot. No, it actually didn't because there was a lot of wind, so it didn't get too hot yesterday, even though they said it was going to be 90. And I wake up and it's not even 11 o'clock and my air conditioner comes on because in the house it's 78 degrees. Listen to me. For you people who run hot, you would hate my house because I'm trying to save energy. So I set it in the summertime when it's this hot at 78. 78 in my house. And my wife still complains sometimes that she's cold. And I'm like, you're freaking insane. So it kicked on. So that means it's 78 degrees in my house, which to me is comfortable. It's warm. But it's like, it's 11 o'clock. So that means at like 3 or 4, my air conditioner is just going to be constantly running. So, ugh. Yeah, Para, you're out there in the in the, you know, nice California, but it's fucking hot as shit there. So, all right, let's get into this. This is what Colin says. By the way, I have my nice little orange. I have one more left, orange flavor ice that I will be partaking in while we listen to the music for a second. He says, hey, fellow music explorers, I've had this set list ready for submission a few days ago, the 12th of May, but my daughters decided to be born a few days ahead of schedule. So as I welcome Elise and Kaya, I think it's Kaya, into the family, let's welcome some new bands to the channel. Congratulations, ma'am. I think it's great. Congratulations. Great, and I would be scared shitless, to be honest, if I were you. Just, I've always told the girls that I've dated in my past or been married to or, you know, talking about marriage or anything like that, when the kids discussion comes up, I always say, like, I'm just going to be honest, if we ever do have kids, you're going to take control and take care of them from like 0 to 10, and I'll do 10 to like 18 or 20. Because I just, the babysitting thing, my parents got divorced when I was really, really young, and long story short, my mom got remarried, had three other kids, one, and then a year later had two twins, so she had twins, but they weren't identical, and I basically raised my three young kids, or three young boys, brothers, half-brothers, for like probably 2 years, changed her diapers and all that stuff, and I'm just not into babysitting. It's the same way as a teacher. I just never wanted to teach elementary school. Even middle school is kind of pushing it. High school, they're in the range of where they like can start thinking for themselves and problem solving through like thinking through philosophical value statements. That's the kind of kid I want to deal with. Even if they're like obstinate, I can deal with those kinds of kids. I just babysitting for the. I think it's necessary and you have to do it, but I hate doing the. You know, stuff that you have to do to take care of a baby. Like make sure it's fed, make sure it doesn't die, make sure, you know, you just gotta do everything for the kid. Not my style. So I'd be scared shitless if I were you, because I'd be in those years where not only do you have one to deal with, you have two at the same time. Like you said, they don't even sleep on the same schedule. Ugh, I would die. All right, so with that said, here is the first band of the day. This is Witherfall, and the song is called End of Time. It's a lyric video. Witherfall is a very recent discovery for me. Ever found a band and thought, how did I not find these guys sooner? Yeah, I think that about Leprous, Haken, and Caligulosaurus every day. Well, that is how I feel about Witherfall. They are a progressive power metal band. Of course, there's the power metal aspect from Los Angeles. And these guys have serious songwriting chops. End of Time is full of energy, but has a chorus and halftime. Woohoo! So look forward to the cap. I will look forward to that. So here is Witherfall with End of Time. Tell me if my voice and the music go well together.
Round us, only time can tell. Lies die slowly. Now in the courtyard sounds a distant bell. It's only there to warn us of some impending hell. I can see it.
Okay, good, thank you.
Rise up from under the
go. Sounds like Michael Romeo. Oh God, is this Symphony X? Sounds very Symphony X to me a little bit. But like, yeah, then. Let's just let it die. Ooh. Definitely digging the support. Kind of reminds me of, that, Fall of America song. The voice. His voice sounds like Fall of America. Yo, what's up, Martin? Yeah, I'm liking it so far. It sounds very Symphony X to me. Yeah, I don't like that as much. Have time. Let's just let it die and fall from our eyes. They poison the well. The promise of paradise alive. We live our lives one step from the end. Oh, cool part here. Very progressive here. Went from like power metal heavy to like progressive. Love this part. Great transition into the to like the from the classical to the regular guitar. Colin, I'm gonna say this is going on the playlist, buddy. Damn. Who are these guys? I can see why you're like, how did I not discover these guys? Very classical. It's at the end. Oh, crack the neck. Oh, it's not the end. We're going to new sections. Is this one of those 12-minute songs? Really cool ending on I expire, and then it kind of expires. Very cute little thing. All right, that's the end of that song. Filter for the next song. I don't remember if I saw, I don't think I saw that, but I'll put a filter on it real quick if I haven't already. Some of these from like from last week already had tons of filters on them. So it might already have a filter on it, but if it doesn't, I'll quickly put one on there. Speaking of filters, sorry, Scott, but Circus Maximus or whatever is done. That video got completely blocked. I don't think it's back up, and I didn't even dispute it because there was like the whole album was disputed, would have to be disputed. So that is in the history books of the channel. to which people will never be able to watch again. So, unfortunately, not Scott, John. I don't know why I said Scott. John, your Dead Letter Circus people are in Dead Letter Circus history. Yeah, I'm sorry. I was getting them mixed up. Dead Letter Circus, Circus Maximus, Scott, John. I mean, what the heck? I hope I'm not showing early signs of dementia. So, no filter? I thought he said filter. Well, we'll see. Wait, where did he say that? I didn't see that. Let me say this quickly about this song. So, I saw that James LaBrie came out with a new single or something like that. And I don't think I've ever listened to any of James LaBrie's side projects. He's the least part of the Dream Theater, you know, part that I don't really care for James's voice. I don't dislike it as much as I used to. I don't dislike it as much as other people do, but I don't like it. but I listened to it because it popped up on my playlist. It's his single, and it's like a ballad. It's kind of like a ballad song. And he sounds really, really good. It actually sounds like Far From Heaven from their Dramatic Turn of Events album, I think is what it was from. And it sounds really good, which I love that, Far From Heaven. But there's a couple times when I was listening to it when he was like, when he does his little vibrato thing, he only does it a couple times, thank God. But I remember thinking very clearly at that moment, like, if James could get rid of that one little stupid thing that he does, I think it would clear up for me a bunch of stuff that I don't like about when he sings. It's when he adds that little stupid over vibrato that just kills the vibe and kills the song. It makes it sound cheesy. Why am I telling you this? Because when I hear that, that is the same sort of feeling. It's like everything else this dude sang was really good, sounded great. I like the tone even, except for when he hit those high-pitched notes. The guitar player in this band is fucking phenomenal. He reminds me of Michael Romeo a lot. So I really like the... When you said that these guys were really good at putting together a song, I can totally see why you said that, because that was a well-put-together song. I liked it. I think it's great. Yeah, full albums do seem to be hard, John. I apologize. So it's gone. But there, I did dispute another one. I can't remember. I think maybe it was Scott's. Maybe that's why I got... Scott, did you have another video blocked? I can't remember who it was, but another video is blocked. I disputed that one, so we'll see if that one comes back up. But I can't dispute too much, because if I dispute three at a time and then I get three strikes, the channel like completely dead. So, all right. yes, the Stratovarius singer is very similar to that. So, yeah. Oh yeah, the Catatonia one is gone for good. That's gone, and I will never listen to Catatonia again. So that's a good reminder. If you guys like Catatonia, and you are thinking you're going to like put them on the channel in one of your sets, don't, because of what happened with Scott's set. I disputed the fact that they blocked it. I said, hey, copyright the shit out of it, take the money, just don't block the video so people can see it and give you exposure. And then they read the review, the dispute, and they still disputed it again and didn't accept the dispute and blocked it. So Catatonia, for that reason, whether it's their fault or their label's fault, is dead to me. They're dead to me. I don't want to expose them on the channel. I don't want to talk about them other than how much I'm pissed off about it. So just keep that in mind. All right, so let's move on to the second one because I'm already talking way too much. He says the next one is Lalu. Lalu, I think is how you say it. The song is The Chosen Ones. This is 7 minutes long. It's the official video, but should be safe for reacting. Okay, I'm going to trust you on that. Prog metal supergroup time. Lalu is a project helmed by Vivian Lalu, who hails from France. Oh, I wonder if Jean-Francois will know them. He is very similar to our Arion, as he writes all the music and performs keyboards while outsourcing different talent for the other instruments and vocals. That's pretty cool. Here we have Jelly Cardarelli. What a name. That's like a nickname, right? His real name is not Jelly. If it is, your parents fucking cursed you. Jelly Cardarelli on drums from Adagio. Hoop, I think it's Hoop. I'm not going to say Jupe because it's a J. I think it's Hoop. Hoop Walters on guitar and bass. And Damian Wilson from Headspace. Oh, Headspace, which is Fall of America. And Threshold on vocals. Simon Mularoni from DGM. That reminds me. Please give us some more DGM on this channel if anybody likes them. I like DGM from the few times we've heard them. I was pretty impressed. DGM contributes some guitar parts, and look who contributes a keyboard solo. None other than Jordan Rudess. Nice, Jordan Rudess. So this is Lalu, and the song is called The Chosen Ones. So here we go, people. Let's kick some shit. Damn, it's a sick beat. Ooh. And his drums sound fantastic. Fuck me, man. You want to talk about good drums? This is good drums. Reminds me of, like, Thomas. Hey! That's the guy that was in the Arion video. He's the singer in Arion. I remember his long hair. His voice. So far, I'm loving the song. And people are conditioned lives, wandering through the maze of these bones. How they fall. It's got like a Haken vibe to it right there. Capturing the souls on display. Oh, his name's Damian, okay. I love his voice. I didn't like the song that he did with Arion. I don't tend to like Arion stuff, but except when he does like funky. Keeping your emotion. Very Haken right there. And he sounds gorgeous. I might even say he sounds better than Ross in his head voice. Oh shit, there's a copyright. Fucking Colin. Fuck. Fucking copyright popped up. Fantastic! Yeah, I, you know what? And that makes me think, John, that Colin, like a lot of people have against Dream Theater, like you, John, I think Colin has a little just blockage to Haken, because this is fucking Haken. If he loves this song, he should love Haken. Dude, this is one of my top songs I've heard on this channel for a long time. Oh, and the drums are fucking fantastic. Look at him, he's got energy when he plays. Yeah, Colin, it totally has a Haken feel, you freak. Just accept it. You have a grudge against Haken. Like John and Adrian have against Dream Theater. And Sasha, you just committed blasphemy. This song is way better than the last song. The last song was good, but very typical. This has got... Oh, this is awesome. What's up, Lewis? Lewis?
Dude.
I'm loving this song. Yes. Oh. Dude, his drums are well mic'd. Dude, this is a great, fantastic fucking song. Seriously, I'm very impressed by his singing. I thought I remember when he was on the Aryan song, it was too like, but, oh, Jordan! Yeah, because Cockroach King sucks in this. That's why. Nice, Jordan. It doesn't suck. It's just not my style of Haken. Ooh. This snare sounds good. Oh, fuck. Are you serious? I got blocked. I had the fucking... Come on, stream. It's been fucking 3 minutes. Let's go. Come on. There we go. We're fucking back. Dude, YouTube is crushing me. So before we get back into the song, I've completely blocked it out. I was going to say to Jason specifically about Haken. Look, everybody's different. Of course, it sounds like Sasha and other people, you know, and John like Cockroach King. They're just, that's not my style. Which, Jason, you tend to be very different than me in what you like. So I'm guessing you would like Cockroach King. I'm different from a lot of Haken fans that I don't like that kind of carnival-y whatever stuff. But you should definitely give him a chance. And Lugman, that is not Ross Jennings. That is, I don't know his name, Damien something. Is that his name, Damien? Fucking fantastic. Fantastic. But I don't know if YouTube has been really crazy or you guys have just been picking songs lately that have just been very blockable. Because I even had the filter on and it got blocked completely. So I just don't know what's going on. maybe the algorithm is heightened to my channel for some reason because it's been blocked a few times lately. I don't know. But anyway, we're back. I've blocked it out, and we'll keep going. And then I'll dispute it once the once it gets blocked overnight. So here we go. Let's continue. Ryan, I like 1985. 1985 is sick. This band is called Lalu, the Chosen Ones. I'm sorry, Jelly, you're fucking awesome at drums, but you gotta change your name. Sorry, I thought, did you say I was close last time? So, what I was saying, Jason, is that the Haken set that I saw that they play, a lot of it I didn't like. There was a couple songs on there that I liked, but a lot of it I didn't like. So, depends on what you like, Jason. You might like it. Yeah, this is probably one of the best songs I've heard on the channel in a long time. His voice was gorgeous. The drums were... And it's not even that his drum parts were fantastic. They were. They were really good, especially at the beginning when he was doing those fills to lead into the song. But it was more that whoever engineered... I've always said, one of the reasons I think Mike Portnoy got so lucky in a lot of ways, is that he came at a time. Timing is everything. So he came at a time that was perfectly set up for like a drummer that was much better than what you're typically hearing on the radio. And he was introducing a style of music and a style of drums that wasn't very common. And he popularized, even though people were doing stuff that he was like the monster fills, people were doing that. But he is credited with kind of, in the drum world, bringing that to like the mainstream where everybody did it. As well, I think he also, maybe this part isn't the lucky part as much. He also, I think one of the reasons, and in my personal opinion, I can't prove this, that he as a drummer took off as what, the 30 time reigning magazine winner or whatever it was because his drum sound, his engineering on almost every album was fucking fantastic. Outside of Images and Words, where he says he hates that trigger that is on his drums, which I don't mind it, but I understand why, and it sounds very different. And I think from Images and Words, he like took control more of the sound of the drums because he didn't like it. But his drums always sound, his snare, his Melody Master snare is so tight, it just sounds fantastic. This guy's drums are very similar. There's a lot of drummers that are good, but like just the sound and the way the drums are engineered takes away from their ability and the overall sound of it. This guy's drums were opposite. It just sounded so well done and fit perfectly. And that singer was gorgeous. Guitar player had a nice little solo there, and then of course Jordan solos are Jordan solos. So I really dug that song. I'm quite impressed, Colin. Really cool, man. Really, really cool. So that song is definitely going on a playlist. Enjoyed it. All right, number three. This is Winter Sun, which we've had on the channel quite a bit, several times, I think. More than three, I think. Maybe three. This song is called Time. It's a live rehearsal. That's interesting. Is this going to get fucking blocked too? This is a 12-minute whopper. So here's a band and song that many may know. Winter Sun have been around since 2003 and are mostly known for their long gaps between albums. Having only done three in almost 20 years of existence, main composer and singer, Yari, don't pronounce the J, just like human, has gone through extended periods of writer's block. That makes sense. There's actually a song called Wither by Dream Theater that addresses that in the lyrics, which is very interesting, which it's a poppy song, but I love it. This song references this by being about time slipping away and being unable to reclaim it. As a 12-minute epic, it goes through a lot of changes but flows perfectly. Special mention has to go to the drummer, Kai Hato, who pours his whole being into this song. He is also the current drummer for Nightwish. Okay. Hopefully he... Well, I guess you can't really change Nightwish's orchestration. All right, so here we go with number 3, 12-minute whopper. Let's go. Oh, do I have this blocked? I think I do. Should I unblock it? I'm pretty sure we've had Winter Sun on here. Maybe it was a different name that I'm getting mixed up. Winter something. Okay, you want me to unblock it? Okay. Alright, Colin. Ooh, I like that acoustic sound. Scott says leave it. Colin says unblock it. Liking this so far. Feels good. All right, Jason, you enjoy your concert tonight, man. We'll be interested tomorrow to hear if you like taping or not. Oh shit, yeah, I've gotta do that. Thanks, BD, for reminding me. Oh wait, I meant to say 2-1. What the fuck? 2-1. Oh, okay. Sorry, Jason. I thought you were saying peace out. Hey, there's Baggins. Baggins, you missed a great song that we just had. Probably one of my favorite songs on the channel in a long time. Liking how this is beginning with a 12-minute song, you can kind of do that. You know what's crazy about the Lost song getting blocked too? I was talking a lot throughout it, so it wasn't like I was just sitting there listening to the song. I think the voice, Colin, is going to be the big part of this song. His voice is cheesy as fuck to take away, but the music so far, great. I do wish the drums were higher in the mix. Oh, you got COVID, Baggins? Actually, I think I feel something in my throat. I hope I don't have it too. It'll be my second time getting it. Okay, where's this going? Where's this going? I like how they're kind of all looking at each other like, are you ready? Yeah, he just went. Baggins, tell us how your symptoms are. You feeling okay? That's why he went like this, because he knew he was going to do that. Yeah. Yeah. This is live? Or is this, to me this doesn't sound live. Sneezing is allergies, man. Dark is the frost, my dying trade to the art of the seven. don't mind his growl or his screaming right now, his growling. I can't believe I'm saying that, but I don't mind it. Okay? Just don't go, ah! See that wave? It's like back here and not up here. Is that your first time getting it, or have you had it before? Yeah, Martine, I think the production could be better as well. Sounds kind of like too compressed or something. Okay, I hope he never goes that high, because right now, I like his voice dominant. Digging this. Yeah, Ryan, that's a good point. I agree with that. Had a Devin feel. Oh, Sasha, don't rub it in. Bet you have like a 10-foot dick too, right, Sasha? German 10-foot dick. Yeah, I don't love this song, but I'm digging it. I don't mind it. Oh, so Ryan has the 10-foot dick too, okay. Ask Ashley about that. Ooh, Scott's liking this one the best. Interesting. Luis, that's called a fever. Yeah, I feel like the song is not changing enough for a 12-minute song. Now maybe as I say that. I like it, I just don't love it. And I like his voice. I mean, that's been my biggest diversion from Colin from the beginning, was he typically chooses power metal that has cheesy vocals. But today is not that. Yes, Martin, that's how I feel. Nothing stands out about this. Ooh, did you hear that sweep? Okay, I like this part. Nice. I'm always impressed with people who can tap like that. Great, man. Different strokes for different folks. Raise the cheese. I've been searching so long. I will find you. Even if it takes my even if it takes my whole life. He's got some passion, I'll give him that. Like, different things, but something that completely misses some people completely hits other people. Great. I love that this song has been getting fucking blocked and warning. That's good. John, I can see that. I love how that drummer's like, I just shat myself. Damn, yeah, he did fucking work it. I think I see, I guess I should say I see it more in the sound than the vocals necessarily. Okay, I will say this, that was a pretty quick 12 minutes. I think my conclusions are the same as everybody else. Like, it just didn't change as much. that's what for me, it just didn't change a ton. Yeah, if it was definitely like half that time, could have been a much better thing. And I'm surprised I didn't mind his growls or his whatever, screaming, whatever you want to call it. It didn't rub me really the wrong way. It actually sounded pretty good. So I'm going with 2-1-3 like Bryce. And let's get into the last one because we're already at 54 minutes because of me talking and because of the stupid takedown. All right, this last one is called Lost Horizon. Or the band is called Lost Horizon, and the song is called Highlander, in parentheses, The One. It's a fan lyric video, and it's another 12-minute song. Okay, so I gotta be honest here, I put this song on here for Sasha. So Sasha, this one's for you, pal. He has mentioned this song a few times in the chat, and I thought, well, I might be the only one to put it forward, so here we go. Lost Horizon was the first band to feature Daniel Hyman, which fucking rocks, as their singer. The band broke up in 2004 after having a disagreement with the main composer and guitarist, Wojciech. I think it's Wojciech. No idea on the pronunciation. Thank you. Thank you that there's somebody else that's willing to say that they're not fucking scholars at pronunciation. Hyman felt he was being asked to push his voice too far, and yeah, you can hear it in this song. Really? He seems like the, like, dude who can't be pushed too far. Maybe I'm thinking of someone else. Hold on to your seats for what has been called the greatest power metal song ever written? Are you serious? That's it for the set. Hopefully everyone found something they liked. If I manage to be here live for this one, it'll be a miracle thanks to the dad duties. Well, you were here, and we appreciate that you were here. Now we got a 12-minute epic called Lost Horizon Highlander that I'm sure Sasha's going to be masturbating behind the camera. Here we go. Do I have to put a filter on this one?
The one pure in his heart, shining fair in the bliss, never lost, no grace.
Manuel already put this one at the top.
Running throughout the fields, in that
hear this power metal of all time song. All right, Luis, peace out, buddy. Did you get my email, Luis? I sent you an email. Great, Luis. Looking forward to it, buddy. But I usually like Daniel Hyman's voice. When he was on that, what's that band called?
Sudden gust in my face, burning rage o'er the clouds.
Okay, I don't like that.
From depth of the glory.
This song very much and what the changes. But for those of you who love this song, what makes this one of the greatest power metal songs of all time? this section is good.
Wish I could fly through this hell.
Like that. For her second song, which is fucking awesome.
Here is
so
my
good.
Life, not a boat. How could I leave this
Like. quite funny, Bryce. I mean, I'll give it to him. That's impressive to be able to do it. Doing that live every night. Okay, wow, we're an hour and 8 minutes. I want to say, I think, Colin, you went into this, I'm going to give you props, because you went into this knowing, I think, that most people were not going to like it, but as you said, you wanted to give Sasha one of his favorite songs, and you just did, so that was for Sasha, which I do have a question. Sasha, are you finished with school for the semester? Are you going to be joining us more often? Because I remember when you said school starts, you get so busy you can't join all that often. So are you going to be joining us more, Sasha? So yeah, I'm going to definitely say, oh, I'm actually surprised Martine liked 4 better than 3. I'm going to say 2, 1, 3, 4. Is that right? 2, 1, 3, 4. Yes. 2, 1, 3, 4 is my pick. Even though number 2 was the one that got this fucking video blocked, it was definitely the best song of the set. It'll be a song that goes on a playlist. Number 1 could go on a playlist. I think it will go on like a heavy gym playlist because I think it had some great riffage, some fantastic guitar work, and I didn't mind the guy's voice. So that right there is a recipe for a good gym song. Very much had a Symphony X feel to it. The 3 didn't really like as much, and definitely didn't like 4. So, tomorrow's set, as I have told you guys, is going to be rather short. I think it's a long song, but it is a song off of a random person who wrote me on email who has joined the channel before, who has finished their own song. They wrote the song. I have no idea what this song is. I mean, it could be fucking rap for all I know. It could be country. I'm guessing, since he's been on this channel before, it's gotta be in like the power metal, heavy metal, progressive kind of style is what I'm gonna guess, but I don't know. I have no idea. It could literally be anime. But he asked, and I'm all about trying to promote people, because nowadays, as you know, for people to be seen and people to be, like, their music discovered, they have to go onto YouTube channels. I think you guys saw it with Outliers, Aviation's Outliers, which made my top 40. You could see every reaction video I've seen with them of that song, they're like the first comment. So they're going around and seeing, it's kind of like they're promoting themselves by commenting on people's videos. So I'm always down for trying to help people out like that. So tomorrow, join us for a rather short set, and then you'll have your Sunday free. And then Monday we have Scott. So yep, there's also a Wicked Storm kicking up here too, JBB. It's on its way. They said probably by 3 o'clock we'll be having some thunderstorms here. So let us know how bad it is. That's okay, Arrow. Not Sasha. Colin has kids crap to get to now. So you guys have a good Saturday. Stay away from the storms. For those of you in Canada and United States, it's like a big line. It's literally from like the bottom of the United States going all the way up through Canada. So it's a big, I don't know, maybe that's the same storms or if it's a different storm line, but that storm line is coming for us. So this video is definitely not going to live more than today. So I will try to dispute it. We'll see how that goes. And I hope that whoever produced the second song is not a dickwad like Catatonia, because if they are and I dispute it and they say no again, that band will be forever dead to me, even though I loved the song. So, all right. Nice job, Colin. We will see you guys tomorrow here. Hopefully support the new guy who's trying to promote his music tomorrow and give your honest thoughts. I told him that. I said, if you're going to put your thing on the channel, just so you know, it's going to be an honest take. So if I don't dig it, I'm going to tell you I don't dig it. So promotion can be a double-edged sword. All right. Peace out, y'all. Have a good Saturday.